Hello, U.S. history people. Today's video coming at you from San Juan Hills High School is to talk to you a little bit about the assignments you've been doing the last few weeks. And then just at the beginning here, we'll talk a little bit about expectations and how we're going to continue moving forward. People doing a great job. Continue to do your assignments, ask questions. We got an email talking about office hours and all these things. We're going to kind of keep things the way we've been doing. We're going to have a video at the beginning of the week. You can reach me any time of day via email. I try to respond to you immediately during a typical school day. If it's on the weekend, it might take me a little while to get back to you. And then continue to email me if you're turning in late work. As of right now, you've got a new COVID-19 special. No late work penalties. That's right. You heard it here first. That doesn't mean to slack off because we're going to be continuing to get work each week and it's going to add up. But if you have people talk to me about jobs, all kind of situations, sometimes some sad situations, so thank you for reaching out. Just get your work in. But you have to email to let me know. Google Classroom doesn't alert me, okay? All right, that's kind of the housekeeping part of this. Now let's get going on to the recap. Okay, so the civil rights movement, wow. I hope you've been moved by some of these things that you've been learning about. It all really goes back to 1896 and Plessy versus Ferguson. That was a Supreme Court case that said states could segregate, keep the races separate, as long as facilities for African-American and whites, as long as it was separate but equal. And so that laid the groundwork for there to be segregation in schools, public places, waiting rooms, public transportation, all those kind of things, there could be segregation. Well, it came to be that things weren't equal. It wasn't necessarily like, oh, we had two different schools and they're both great. No, typically, the African-American school got secondhand books. Sometimes the facilities were, second rate. They were falling apart. So separate but equal was not equal. And just the act of segregating creates inequality. So slowly this movement was starting to build up. We're going to, from 1896, right, that you start going through and they're just, we're little things that were starting to come up saying like, okay, we need to challenge this. A big part of this was, FDR, well, first of all, having African Americans move throughout the country instead of staying in the South after World War I, that started to change because African Americans could vote in some of these new communities. So some challenges to segregation were coming up. FDR and the New Deal and all that, the Democratic Party started to be more sympathetic to equal rights. So there were slowly things, challenges to this segregation. However, we didn't have anything like major, huge, until the Brown versus Board of Education. That was in 1954. And the NAACP, the National Association for the Advancement of Colored People, they had some court case victories before that, but they were really gearing up towards this court case, Brown versus Boards of Education, to say, hey, look, education is not equal when it's separated. And so they all got a bunch of different families together and focused it really on the Brown family and to say, okay, we're gonna challenge this. This girl, Linda, she's a little girl, she had to travel blocks and blocks and blocks to go to the African-American school. And so they're like, all right, let's challenge this. Let's say that it's not an equal school. This is a ridiculous situation. And so the NAACP hires lawyers and they're gonna go for it, okay? And so Brown versus Board of Education challenge segregation in schools. And oh my gosh, period, 1, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9. It turns out that the Supreme Court said, yes, this is not equal. We're gonna do away with segregation in schools. The verbiage they used, they said that school districts had to proceed with all deliberate speed in integrating the schools. That was a little vague, so then we saw some problems, especially in Arkansas, right? What does deliberate speed mean? There wasn't a timeline. It wasn't, in 5 weeks, we have to have all schools integrated. It said with all deliberate speed. So some states dug in their heels. They wanted to keep segregation the law of the land. So your assignment, the Little Rock Nine. Wow, I hope you saw how powerful that was. The bravery involved with those students that decided, hey, we're going to challenge, segregation in Arkansas and just the challenges they had to face. And then hopefully you watched the clip years later at the Oprah segment where the students met each other again. And just the power of, the bravery and just looking at the sadness of the racism, but then also the forgiveness. So that's what I think this movement really talks about. Bravery, courage, sadly just the awfulness of the racism, and then, the forgiveness and the fortitude of the different people involved in this movement. Pretty impressive. Okay, so then moving on to the Montgomery bus boycott, that's Martin Luther King Jr. really coming on the scene in a major way. His nonviolent protests, that's what you know, Rosa Parks, and they decided to challenge the bus system being segregated in Montgomery, Alabama. That went on for a year, 1 year. Carpools, walking. I mean, it was like people's lives were disrupted, but they were committed to challenging segregation in the bus system. And sure enough, the Supreme Court said that that was unlawful for there to be segregated buses in Alabama. Another victory. So, Martin Luther King Jr. becoming, you know, prominent and famous, nonviolent protest, all that thing, all those kind of things. You were then supposed to look at Freedom Riders. Now, interstate travel, that means traveling between the states. That was supposed to be an integrated situation. However, there were certain states that in waiting rooms, in certain buses, in places, there was still segregation. So these Freedom Riders said, hey, we're going to challenge this. And so mainly African Americans, but also some white people joined in on the protests, and they were going to travel on these buses and wait in places in waiting rooms they weren't supposed to be. Oh my gosh, classes. They were met with such violence and ambushed, and their buses, firebombed. It was insane the things that they went through, and they weren't going to stop. It was just one of those things that the protesters were really trying to put pressure on President Kennedy to step up and, you know, enforce, you know, do away with segregation and enforce some of the laws that were already in place. But oh my gosh, class, we've learned that the Cold War was going on. And, you know, we've got all these things happening with Russia and the Kennedys and Bay of Pigs, so many things going on. And so Kennedy was a little reluctant to do anything. But the Freedom Riders didn't give up, and they continued to protest and continued to put their lives on the line. And then finally, in 1962, Robert Kennedy and John F. Kennedy decided to, you know, put the pressure on the South and end segregation and interstate travel. Another big victory. Then you were to look at James Meredith. That was a African-American who was in the armed forces, and he was going to challenge University of Mississippi. University of Mississippi was still segregated. It should have been taken care of. This is the 60s. 1954 was Brown versus Board of Education. He was attacked. There was all kinds of protests. Kennedy eventually had to call in the army to allow James Meredith to continue to go to classes. Just again to kind of show where the country still was with integration. It still had a long way to go. And then we finished up our last couple weeks, and you looked at the letter from the Birmingham jail and that protest situation. Martin Luther King Jr., and sometimes he'd be criticized for this, he wanted to have a situation where he was going to show that there were still major amount of racism happening in the South, particularly in Alabama. And he was just going to engage in a peaceful protest, nonviolent protest, but he knew that it would cause a reaction. The protesters would be arrested for, you know, unlawful conduct and disturbing the peace and all, but he knew that was coming. And Martin Luther King Jr., you know, wanted to have a spectacle. And sure enough, that's what they got. The protesters again were beaten. They you know, violence ensued. Martin Luther King Jr. was arrested and he was put in jail. So, the whole thing that we're trying to get to is, Martin Luther King wanted Kennedy to let's get a major civil rights act passed in Congress that's gonna enforce voter registration, enforce voting, do away with segregation. Let's have a big civil rights bill passed through Congress, and that's what we're aiming towards. That's what you're gonna cover in this week's assignments, that getting passed, and what does that look like, and what was that, and what was that all about. So that's kind of a recap video, kind of a longer one today. Takeaways. Hopefully, you know, you got something out of our civil rights assignment so far. I hope you have. If you haven't watched the movie Selma, I would recommend at this point that you watch that movie. It's very powerful and deals with what's happening. And that was more of that was dealing with voter registration and the power of voting. So check that out. Continue to just do a great job with your assignments. And again, you know, as far as what this class looks like online and distance learning, we're kind of in our groove, and we're going to continue to do what we've been doing. And please feel free to have you or your parents email me at any time, day or night, During a typical school day, I'll try to reply to you immediately. If it's after hours, maybe the next day, but I want us to have great communication. I want you to feel like you're getting something out of these assignments and that you feel supported. So that's my main goal. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please don't hesitate to reach out. I hope you guys are doing well. And all right, I'll talk to you soon.